Hey guys, Godzilla101 here, and welcome to a different sort of video. Today we're going to be reacting to, today we're going to be power scaling, actually. Yeah, I'm clapping my hands because, you know, nobody else will. Today we're going to be power scaling Godzilla. Well, obviously, you can see by the title. Today we're going to be power scaling Godzilla singular point. We're going to be power scaling the Godzilla from Godzilla singular point, basically. So, yeah, I thought this would be a, you know, cool little idea, you know, something to do since, you know, I can't really react to videos since my audio is completely messed up. But, hey, I thought this would be a cool little thing to do for you guys, you know, just something new and unique to add to the channel. Now, before we start, I should say we are going to be going over every form of Godzilla singular, of every form of Godzilla that appeared in Godzilla singular point. That means a Godzilla Aquarius, Godzilla Terrarius. We're going to be power scaling all of them. So, yeah, if you got all that, it should be an easy concept to get. And, yeah, screw it. I just thought we'd do Godzilla singular point since technically he's the newest Godzilla we've got. So, yeah, without further ado, let's just get into this. Alright, so to start off with Godzilla Aquarius, there's not really much to say about him, surprisingly. Well, not really surprisingly, since he's the first form of Godzilla singular point, but yeah, I mean, he's strong, like, compared to normal real life standards. You know, he destroys a couple of boats, you know, he jumps over a ship blockade, so, you know, that's pretty cool. He also hunts and kills a few Nanda, you know, whatever. The only really interesting thing to talk about is like his sheer size. So, like, by sheer size standards, because when he jumps, okay. So, the scene where he jumps onto land and kills the Manda, that's like, he's huge in that scene. So, I would say by sheer size alone, he should be comparable to, like, average building to large building level, or maybe city block level, to be honest. In, maybe in between one of those, you could argue maybe city block, maybe, or argue town level, possibly, or just city level. But, yeah, I think the more fair and reasonable assumption would be he's, like, large building level, or at best large building level to small, well, not small, normal building level, you know, just by sheer size. Doesn't really have any abilities, doesn't really have anything going for him very much, other than, you know, speed in the water. But, you know, basically all Godzillas have that. So yeah, I would say he's definitely large building to building level. I think that's a fair comparison to make for him. And yeah, let's move on to his other form. Alright, now, unlike Godzilla Aquarius, or whatever you want to call it, Godzilla Terrarius actually has very, very good feet. So, the first feat to start off with is he causes a 500-meter-tall explosion. If you remember that scene, which is probably playing on screen right now, but I have it blocked up with pictures. In the anime, it happens with, like, this red vapor comes out and he creates like this huge explosion and all that stuff, and he generates a massive energy burst that could be observed from many kilometers far away from Tokyo by merely transforming. So when he when he transforms, he generates a humongous explosion that can be seen all across Tokyo. Like, you literally cannot be in Tokyo and not see it. Like, it's crazy. So that easily puts him easily at small town level and small city. Well, probably not small town level, probably large city level, if I'm being completely honest. So city level, he definitely does. Or if you want to lowball him, you could be like, he's small town level, which is, makes no sense at all, considering he literally did an entire thing that he literally did vapor, ice beam, whatever you want to call it, that had covered the entire city of Tokyo. So yeah, I don't really see how that's town level, but whatever. Yeah, no, he's definitely a large city level, or if you don't want to say large city level, at least small city level, at least, because this guy is insane. And it's, what's crazy is that's not even his best feat yet, or not his best feat in the entire show anyway, because when we get back from our little cutaway, we're gonna get to the real movie breaking video. We already know who that is. So yeah, let's not waste any more time. Godzilla Terrarius is a very, very strong, easily large city level. Maybe you can put him at mountain level, possibly, but I'm just highballing at this point. And yeah, let's get into the real meat and potatoes of this video. Alright, Godzilla Ultimate. We are finally at what you guys have been waiting for. Now, this guy is definitely got some insane feats on him. First off, he's stronger and bigger than before. And the just by transforming, he generated 1,000 earthquakes over an hour across Tokyo. So, yeah, easily above large city level. Possibly, not possibly, definitely mountain level. Definitely. With his atomic breath, he's definitely large mountain level. Easily. At least, he's at least 2 times stronger than before due to having an increased his size 100 meters, which then translates to 1.2, 18.2, 0.92 megatons. Big brain me. so he grows bigger, he's definitely stronger, and with the combination of atomic breath and Jet Jaguar's orthogonal beam that he shoots out with Godzilla's atomic breath, generate enough energy to disperse the red dust over Tokyo. And remember, Tokyo is fucking huge. I don't remember the exact number of how big it is, but I remember the megatons of force, but I don't remember the size of the city. I'm stupid like that. Big brain, trophy instantly taken away. But I'm gonna put up a number for how big Tokyo is. But yeah, man, that's insane. That's fucking crazy. And what's crazy is we're not really even done. I've been actually really interesting scaling for potentially how much stronger Godzilla can be in the future. And now I'm gonna bring up some scaling that I don't think, or probably nobody has ever brought up, but I've read some couple of things and rewatched some things from the Godzilla anime, and I think I have some pretty crazy scaling for you guys. So Godzilla is obviously a higher dimension. Godzilla is a higher dimension than ours, obviously, if you've seen the anime. As Ashura's materials, which studies the similar points, mention non-cool geometry dimensional topolia category theory in abstract algebra. I'll fucking put it up on the screen, y'all. I can't fucking read all this well. There's also a scene which explains how Godzilla we see is nothing compared to its true form. It is literally an analogy of higher dimensional beings in singular points. So, if you've seen the anime, you know that's fucking crazy and insane. And in the same scene with Japanese dubs, it describes as an angle from a higher dimension. So basically, when interacting with our dimension, we only observe and interact with a portion of its true form, while the other part of its form is its home dimension. So basically, in layman's terms, the Godzilla we're seeing is not actually Godzilla. It's just a small, teeny bitty portion of the real Godzilla, which is a fucking dimension. So, with that being said, the singular point Godzilla has the potential to be reality, dimension level. Like, he's dimension level, bro. What more scaling I have is that Godzilla is the pinnacle of singularity points that can access the final changes of the archetype, which will evolve over time and create a catastrophe that will destroy the entire universe without Gaia's existence. So, what that means is, if Godzilla's signal is SP, Godzilla's true form got ever shown, that means it would overlap our universe and completely destroy it. It erased it out of existence. It's that strong. So yeah, man, the singular point Godzilla is possibly the strongest Godzilla out there. It's definitely underrated in my opinion. His power is completely underrated. I definitely think he's one of the, if not the strongest Godzilla out there. I know comics Godzilla have some pretty wacky scaling. Godzilla in Hell has some intense scaling. I hopefully if this video does well, I'll probably do that soon. But yeah, man, Godzilla singular point is a monster. He is a beast of a kaiju, and he definitely beats Goku. He 100% beats Goku. Jokes on this this channel. But yeah, man, that's gonna be up today's video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. I know I did. This was really fun making. This was a lot of fun making. Hopefully you guys have a new appreciation for. If you guys want to see more videos like this in the future, please let me know. And thank you guys so much for watching this video all the way to the end. Leave a like, subscribe, comment who you want me to make a video on next time, and